LEGO Worlds is an incredible game. It's like having an endless bucket of Legos. You can build a huge castle or a small house in the clouds. Learn how to design and create your own world with me in this tutorial series. Become a master designer slash builder. In this series, you'll learn how to design and build many different architectural styles. We'll cover lighting, furnishing, and decorating, interior and exterior spaces. We'll build castles, dungeons, bridges, skyscrapers, and even a spaceship. So get your game ready and follow along. Hey guys, welcome back to Designing and Building in LEGO Worlds. I'm Brandon. This is Max. Over here, Max. Max is pretty excited because we are in Monster Town. Monster Town is part of the Monsters Pack DLC in LEGO Worlds. It was just released about a week ago and it adds a whole bunch of new content onto the game. Now we love this town so much that we are going to build a really cool building here. We are going to build a Gothic church right here on this lot. Gothic architecture is an architectural style from Europe in the High and Middle Ages. You see it a lot in religious buildings, and there's a lot of skyscrapers from the 30s and 40s with Gothic architectural components. Gothic architecture is characterized by pointed arches, ribbed vaults, and flying buttresses, among other things. We think this style is absolutely perfect for Monster Town. Now Max wanted some inspiration, so we went to Flickr and we typed LEGO Church into the search bar, and we found one that we really like. Now we can't build this exactly because we don't have all the pieces, so we're going to make some substitutions, and we're going to make a lot of changes. It will be similar, but it will be Max's own unique design. Now just like in real life, if you are building with real Legos, the first thing you'd want to do is take a look at your base plate and see how much space you have. We've got a pretty good sized base plate, but we want to build some cool things around the church as well. We're going to figure out where the middle of the base plate is and then start building the foundation of the church. Alright, so Max was kind enough to fast forward a little bit and because it took us a little while to get this figured out. So what we did here is we laid out our foundation and we put all of the essential items in that we knew we wouldn't really be able to change once we started building the walls. So the first thing we wanted to do is make sure that we have an even number of studs in between the arches. So we've got three arches on either side and we have about eight studs between each arch. We also wanted to make sure that our roof would be okay and fit properly, and it looks like it's gonna fit great. It's going to sit inside of the outside walls, just as if you were building in real life. Spend a little bit of time, lay out your foundation, make sure that everything is going to work, because once you start building upward, it's going to be a lot harder to change the foundation. Now that we've laid all of this out and we know it's going to work, we're going to remove the arches and the roof piece. Now we're going to start building up the foundation. Now we don't want the walls to be perfectly flat, because LEGO builds look so much cooler when there's a lot of detail. So we're going to start placing the next level of bricks. Okay, we just added a second layer of bricks. Now we added it to the outside because we didn't want to make our inside smaller. We also painted the bricks. We're not going to do black because you can't change the color of the arches we're going to use, and the arches are gray. We're going to do some cool things with different colors later on in the build. Now that we've built up the walls several levels, we're going to add the arches. The next thing that we're going to do is add some details underneath the arches. Now that we've added in some details around the arches, we're going to build the main parts of the walls. Max doesn't think these arches look quite tall enough, so we're going to remove the arches and put in some extra 1x1 bricks so that we can make them taller. Now the arches don't seem to want to go on top of where we want to put them, so we're going to have to fake it a little bit by putting a brick across the open area and then deleting it. Good job, Max. That is looking much more Gothic with the very tall archways. Now we're going to build the wall up to the top of the arches. We're going to make the outside columns a little bit thicker so we can add some more detail. In the Gothic style of architecture, details are abundant, so we're going to add as many details as we can and keep building the walls up. The next thing we're going to do is build up the walls around the front door. We're going to add some more details to this, but for now we want to get the general shape of the front of the church finished. Looks like Max has got quite a crowd gathering down here. They look pretty excited to check out this church. We want the lines of the lower portion here to continue up further. So to do that, we're going to add another layer of blocks on the outside, just along the corners. We've removed some of the bricks from the top of the tower because we want to build some windows on each side. So to do that, we're going to build a frame. Now we're going to add another level of detail to the outside. Now we're going to add a pointed roof to the very top of the tower, and to do that, we're going to use some slope pieces. Now Max is going to add some details to the top of the tower and around the windows. Since we can't place arches up here, we're going to try to create the effect with the 1x1 plate. Max has added a lot of cool detail to the top of the tower, and we are going to continue adding details along these sections. When you're adding details, you want to avoid leaving large sections of flat walls, cause they're kinda boring. Just be creative and try different things and see what you like. Before we get too far on the exterior, we're going to work on the interior, because just like in real life, it's a lot easier to build the inside of a Lego building before you've built the outside. We're going to use the 1x1 plate and the transparent colors to create a stained glass window that we can copy and paste. Now that we've got our window just the way we want it, we are going to copy and paste it to each of the empty windows. Now that we've got all of the windows placed, we're going to do some more detail work on the interior before we put the roof on. This is a great time to get some of the roof placed. We're going to put a few of the pieces in so that we have the general structure. Since we have the whole back wall open, we can actually go ahead and fill in the roof, because we'll still be able to easily work on the interior. Thank you. Now we're going to add some fence bricks along the edges of the roof. We've added detail to the columns and made them taller and taper towards the top. This way, they form a buttress. Buttresses were used in medieval times to help support the weight of the incredibly heavy roof and walls. If you need a little inspiration, just look at the other buildings in LEGO Worlds, especially the buildings in Monster Town. They have a lot of really cool details. Another really cool Gothic architectural detail is called a flying buttress. We've added two sets of flying buttresses to the outside of the building. We're going to copy this and place it wherever there is a structural pier. Now that we've got the outside mostly finished, this is a good time to work on the floor. We're going to start with a layer of black plate. You'll see why in a minute. Now we're going to place random round and square tiles throughout. Because we're using some round tiles, whatever's underneath will show through. And that's why we've put a layer of black tiles underneath. Now we're going to use the 1x1 flat tile to fill in all the rest of the spaces. When you're laying tiles like this, just keep dragging and it will go right through the others and continue to lay. You don't have to click your mouse button a bunch of times. Now that we've finished our floor, we're going to add some lighting to the interior. Max is having a little bit of trouble placing these torches next to each other, so we're going to stagger them. Maybe we'll do one a little bit higher than the other, like this. That looks pretty cool. If something is not working out quite right, don't get frustrated, just change it up a little bit. Now that we've finished lighting up the interior, we're going to work on the back wall. We're going to create a stepping effect and put in some really cool windows. Alright guys, Max is feeling pretty good about the progress we've made so far in this episode. In the next episode, we're going to landscape the exterior and continue to add details to the church. Hey Max, you liking the church so far? Oh, that's not the reaction I was expecting. He's like, dang it, it's not done yet. Max, you like the church so far? Yeah? Yeah? Yep, okay, he does. He likes it a lot. Max, why don't you give the nice people a little tour here before we end the episode? So in here is the main part of the church. We've got these beautiful vaulted ceilings. We've got these awesome columns here that continue from the ground all the way up through the ceiling. We have these beautiful stained glass windows where you can see the night sky. And then we wanted to keep the back wall open because we really wanted to see that really cool, dark, and scary moon. So we've left as much of that open as possible. We've lit the interior with these cool monster torches, and then we've also added some candelabras here for extra lighting. Here's the entry. We're going to add a door in the next episode. And on the sides, we have these really cool flying buttresses. You'll definitely see these flying buttresses a lot in Gothic and medieval architecture. All right, Max, climb up to the roof. Don't break anything. We spent a lot of time on this building. Come on, Max. There we go. All right, we have this beautiful black roof that's shingled. And then we've got some guy up here that has a teddy bear. We're gonna want that teddy bear. We just gotta find a black potion for him. All right, so on the roof, we can see the top of the church tower here. It goes up pretty high, and we have a steeple up there. And you can see the light coming from the windows and lighting up the buttresses. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Max says he's had a lot of fun building this church, and he's really excited for the next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Bye.